NFCA is a Nigerian Football Coaches Association, the Coaches Association of Nigeria, in which I'm the training officer for Oyo State chapter, while Ladambozo is the president of national body. NFCA Association is the Coaches Association is a bunch of coaches. Either you are a professional, or either you are an elite coach, or you are an amateur coach. Thank God that we just finished the election and I was elected as a training officer. You know, at times, coaches need people to train them too. And you know, if you want to train coaches, you have to be knowledgeable too. And I think my people in the States, they may feel that I can stand in that. That's how I was get elected. You know, when we started the academy, the person in charge then believe that I'm more closer to grassroots, and they want the academy to be a baby to the main team, where in the next 2, 3, 4 years we'll be seeing young players to adopt in the main team. So when we started, I was given the director for the academy, and thank God for now, we have almost 300 students that comprises of under 13, under 15, and under 17. And thank God our coaches, we have the capable coaches from different grassroots clubs to take care of the academy according to the AKEDA. Like I told you, why the club been established. You understand me? I told you, I said, the philosophy of the club is to look after the young ones, how they grow from under 13 to 15, from 15 to 17. And we've told all of them that this is our philosophy. If you are an exceptional to the age of 17 years, definitely you will play main club. You will play the main team. Yes, first of all, we will thank our governor for that, because that was the only place in the state to train. It is the only place that it's been a good side, good stadium to train our players. But thank God for our governor that he see it as one of his agenda to rebuild the stadium. But now, and thank God the pandemic don't even allow us to train. You know, it really affects a lot. But now we've adopted a school, that's Lola College, Odife Road. They've given us the place. It's good, it's durable for young players to train too. So by next 2 weeks, I think we'll start training there. It affects a lot. You know, we deal with young boys and we shouldn't expose them to danger. That's why we call it off. We call our training off. Immediately we see the whole world is being affected by COVID. And thank God that we are coming out of it. If you can see, for the past 6 months now, we haven't done anything on footballing. And you know, it's not good for these young children that are growing. Like somebody that is under 15 now and want to go for a competition that is under 15. We cannot go now, and it will not have any advantage of representing us in the under 15 again, because by next year, most of them will have been under 16. So it's really affect, especially the boys at the under 17, because before the COVID, we are planning to go for an invitation tournament in Jos, but you know, those boys, they don't really get happy when we call it off. So it really affect a lot, really, really affect. You know, in the olden days, it's not the parent that will first identify, it's the teachers. But nowadays, tell me, either private school or government school. How many schools that have a playground? That I were a teacher with breath notice of one boy, look at that boy, he's playing table tennis here, he's playing football, see how he's holding ball, you know? So it's the teacher that will call on parents, we allow them, that your boy, he's a very good boy and he's very good in football. So, but immediately, teachers allow a parent like that, parents have to cook up from there. But nowadays, you know, most parents are so busy, even to take note of what the boys are doing in education itself, it's a big problem. That's why I said in our academy, I do advise the parents, sir, fine, education is utmost. But you know, talent, if you get your Bible, you heard what God says about talent. Talent can push you to any level that you don't expect. These are all the things we do tell our parents. You know, this is our job. Because when you go for scouting like that, we do go to schools, primary schools, secondary schools, and where they are playing one or two, five aside, seven or seven aside or nine aside, we do go there. When we see an exceptional players, we meet their parents. We used to advise them, get notice of this boy, he's a good player. This boy can get to places if you are solidly behind him. You know, because grassroots, you know, at the age of 7, 8, you might not know what the boy will be. But when it's getting to age of 15, sir, when it's getting to age of 15, it's going to be cleared that this boy is an exceptional player that will go places. So, but from under 10, all the parents must at least encourage these boys so that when they get to that level, they can encourage them more. That was the question my commissioner asked me when we started the academy. But we put it online that female, we do train female too. You know, I was once a chief coach of Arole Queen that went to Norway to play a tournament then. I introduced it to the academy too that we can take care of the female. But what is happening nowadays? Yeah, you understand? What is happening in our society now? At times give fear to parents to release their female children to come and mix up with men, with male children. So it's really a big challenge, you know, to take up a female player.